very good morning and a very warm welcome to everybody. I say a very warm welcome, you better appreciate it, because I'm told that it's going to be a very, very cold weekend coming up. So we must be prepared. Our intro hymn this morning is The Church's One Foundation.
I wonder if we could go back to verse 2, or Norma, whoever's on the thing there. Some of you know this story, but I just think it's such a wonderful story that it bears repeating. Are we going to get it? You might remember, well, you all know the little town of Colenso, up in the Midlands, up that way, yes, named after Bishop Colenso, yes? Bishop Colenso was the first bishop of Natal. He was here in the late 1850s and 60s. Bishop Colenso had a view of the gospel which was way ahead of his years. He believed in a relational gospel, and he believed that it was all about meeting up with God through Jesus Christ. And when he went out to the Zulus up north, he started to preach the gospel, but found that the Zulus couldn't quite click as to what he was getting at. And so he found out about Nkulunkulu, the God, the Zulus, and he started to tell them about Nkulunkulu. And he wrote a number of books. One of them was a commentary on the book on the letters to the Romans. And they didn't like it in England. In England, they said, this is what the church is about, and anybody who's not a Christian is a savage, and this is what they should be taught. And Colenso said, no, you got it all wrong. My people and my diocese need to meet Jesus Christ. And so they had a huge, big argument, and eventually the Archbishop of Cape Town was drawn into it, and he actually suspended Colenso. And it was so serious that all the bishops of the world got together in 1872, I think it was, 1873, and they had the first of the gatherings of bishops, Lambeth Conference. And this hymn that you've just sung was written for that conference. Called out from every nation, yet one through all the earth, her charter of salvation, one Lord, one faith, one birth. And the writer of the hymn was trying to say, come on, we are united here. Of course, as most of you might know, Colenso was eventually thrown out as bishop. He was disgraced. And it was about 10, 15 years ago that a movement was started to actually reinstate him to his rightful place as the first bishop of Natal. So that hymn you've just sung was all about us here in Natal and our first bishop.
Thank you, Rob. That was a very interesting little story that we heard, and one that I certainly had not heard before. Hallelujah. Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Praise the Lord.
Praise him, you servants of the Lord.
Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Blessed be his name now and forever.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Together. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us confess our sins, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with our neighbor. Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, in penitence we confess that we have sinned against you through our own fault, in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have left undone. For the sake of your Son, Christ our Lord, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy on us, pardon our sins, and set us free from them. Confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and keep us in eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Triune God, Jesus prayed that we might be one. Help us to transcend our differences and find our unity in Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
May we have the reading, please, Glenda.
First reading is taken from 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verses 7 to 11. To each is given the manifestation of the Spirit of the common good. To one is given through the Spirit in the utterance of wisdom, and to another the utterance of knowledge, according to the same Spirit. To another, faith by the same Spirit. To another, gifts of healing by the one Spirit. To another, the working of miracles. To another, prophecy. To another, the discernment of spirits. To another, faith by the same Spirit. To another, gifts from healing by the one Spirit. To another, the working of miracles. To another, prophecy, to another, the discernment of spirits, to another, various kinds of tongues, to another, the interpretation of tongues. All these are activated by one and the same Spirit, who allots to each one individually, just as the Spirit chooses. Hear the word of the Lord.
The appointed psalm for today is Psalm 16, the song of trust and security in God, a miktam of David. Together. Protect me, O God, for in you I take refuge. I say to the Lord, you are my Lord, I have no good apart from you. As for the holy ones in the land, they are the people in whom is all my delight. Those who choose another god multiply their sorrows, their drink offerings of blood. I will not pour out or take from their names upon my lips. The Lord is my chosen portion and my cup. You hold my lot. The boundary lines have fallen for me pleasant places. I have a goodly heritage. I bless the Lord who gives me counsel. In the night also my heart instructs me. I keep the Lord always before me, because he is at my right hand. I shall not be moved. Therefore my heart is glad, and my soul rejoices. My body also rests secure. For you do not give me up to Sheol, or let your faithful ones see the pit. You show me the path of life. In your presence there is fullness of joy. In your right hand are pleasures forevermore. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. shall now sing, O Thou who comest from above. Listen to the good news proclaimed in the Gospel of John, chapter 20, verses 21 to 23. Glory to Christ our Savior. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." When he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." This is the Gospel of Christ. Praise to Christ our Lord. We'll say the Nicene Creed together. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
In the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. If you have been following the... am I using two mics at the moment? I think I am. Is that better? There we go. If you are following the readings for the Holy Spirit season that we are in here at All Souls, you'll know that the one phrase that is being used for today is for the common good. For the common good. Paul, as he when he writes to us, describes us, the body of Christ, as a body. And he puts it in all sorts of different terms, like, you know, the eye can't say to the ear, I don't need you, and all the rest of it. And there's no one part that is more important or less important than another. I have a friend here in Salt Rock who got terrible cancer, and he got cancer in his upper jaw. And by the time they had finished operating on him, he'd lost his right eye, his upper jaw on the right-hand side, and his whole mouth and everything is disfigured on the right side, and he has a big patch of skin over his eye. Some of you may know him. His name is Harold McMillan. Now, Mac is one of those larger-than-life type of people. He would walk in here, and immediately you know that Mac has arrived. He'll walk into the kids' ministry, and he'll say, I'm a pirate, because he's only got one eye. So, you know, all the kids think he's fantastic as well. But what... all the outer show of Mac does is hides in a way what he hasn't got on his face. In that you and I, when we look at something down the road or in the distance or in fairly close to, our eyes tell us how far away that is. Why? Because we've got two eyes and they fix on a point, and they're sending messages to the brain which tell you it is so far away. If you don't believe me, next time you're sitting at the dinner table and somebody asks you for the salt and you reply, I'm sorry, I can't reach it, you know that before you put your hand out, because your brain has already told you, I've looked with your eyes and I've worked out the angles and you can't reach it. That's how your body works. And so we see this with my friend Mac, that he only has one perception, if you like. And so he has coped by developing all sorts of other mechanisms whereby his body can get on through life. And get on through life, it certainly does. He is a great evangelist. He loves going on mission and spreading the gospel of Jesus Christ. Another story I'd like to tell you is a story about a person that some of you know well, my wife Sarah. Now Sarah had a small problem with her left leg, and she needed to have an operation on it, and Dion Steer, the surgeon here, operated on her, and had to go quite deep into her leg to sort out the problem. Now, the scar has healed up beautifully. Everything is fine. But inside her leg, there's a whole lot of nerves which were either touched or slightly nicked or whatever during the operation. And they're all linking back up again. Now, those of you who've ever had cut nerves that are rejoining will know what it's like. If you want an illustration, take the red wire and the black wire, make sure the power is on, and come close, and you'll see bang. That's what nerves do, because nerves are trying to say, hello, we're supposed to be joined up, and I've got a signal for you. And if you're nearly in range, I'm going to try and get to you. And poor Sarah has, we'll be sitting watching television in the evening, and suddenly she'll go, oh! Wake me up. No, I don't sleep during television, I say. And it's these nerves joining up, working away in the body. Now, the way Paul puts it is that the body all needs to be working together. We need each other. One of my favorite examples is you look at that little toe down on the bottom of your foot, on the right-hand side of the bottom of your foot. It's a tiny little toe. But if something happens to that toe, you stub it, or pray God it doesn't happen, but something happens and you lose that little toe, it throws your whole body out. You know what it's like when you stubbed it against the bed leg, you're hobbling around. One little piece of the body affects the whole body. And so it is with whether we're talking about nerves, or whether we're talking about eyes, or ears, or whatever it is, we know that we need each part of the body. And that's what Paul is trying to get across to us. Imagine your body. It needs to be working so that you can do what God wants you to do. But then Paul takes that image wider. And he says, now what I want you to do is to imagine, those of you who are sitting in church today, imagine you are called the body of Christ. You're the body. You're all part of it. Each part of you. And you can say if you want to, no, I don't want to be part of the body. Well, as one of my friends, also a priest, once said, that's fine. But you know, if you are a foot and you decide you don't want to be a part of the body anymore and you go sit over in the corner, in no time at all, you're going to be a very rotten, smelly foot. Because you need the rest of the body for circulation and, don't you? So we are all part of the body. That's what Paul is saying. And this is where we come back now to common good. Because we all need to be working with each other. And I know one of the things that we struggle with in the church, and it is true, and I can speak from long experience, we say, well, it's okay because the priest will do it. And on your way out of church, you'll say, oh, I noticed the bulb was out in the light up there. Will you see something? Will you fix it, please? The priest must do it. That's right. I used to say to people in my congregations, thank you so much. I spent 3 years in theological college to learn how to change bulbs. Or, and this is where our church here at All Souls has to be very careful, we say it's okay, we've got Norma. Or it's okay, we've got Cara. Now, is that fair? Or are we just saying, right arm, you're the one who's doing all the work. And the legs and the toes and the other arm and the fingers and everything else. No, you don't need to work. It's okay, we've got this right arm. It works all right. Not fair. And that's what Paul's trying to get across to us. Now, I know those are pretty heavy examples. And there is nothing wrong with Norma's ministry at all. In fact, it's a miraculous ministry. And Cara, too, does an amazing job. Your clergy have always done an amazing job for you. But your part is also there for the common good. And you might say, well, okay, within this context of Holy Spirit, what does that mean? What does that mean? And we have scriptures which are telling us that each one of us, through our baptism, and those of us who are Anglicans, if we want to really get down to it, when you were confirmed, what did the bishop say as he prayed over you? Do you remember those of you who are confirmed? You came and you knelt down in front of the bishop, and he put his hands on you, and you carried a little card so that he could say, Bridget, or Simon, or whatever, receive the Holy Spirit for the ministry and work of God. Now that's not an empty prayer. Receive the Holy Spirit, each one of you. And maybe later on, as you went through some sort of awakening experience and gave your life to Jesus Christ, as you did that, the Holy Spirit flooded into you. And we pray it time and time again, renew us, refresh us, come Holy Spirit, inspire us. And we really mean it. But what do we want the Holy Spirit for? We want the Holy Spirit to inspire us so that we can play our part in the body of Christ. Just another couple of small examples. This morning when you came in through the entrance, Derek was standing at the desk. And he was writing down, or you wrote down your name, and he was telling you what your temperature was and just checking that all was well. Derek was performing a ministry. And so it is for you too. It might be something small. It might be something big. It might be giving somebody a lift to the shops or the doctor. It might be simply smiling at somebody who's feeling unhappy. But use your gift. All that God has given you for the body, for the common good. That's our encouragement for today. We are one together in Jesus Christ. What a wonderful hymn that Norma probably chose. The church's one foundation. It's all about unity. We're one together. Let's pray. Lord God, Heavenly Father, you made us just as we are. Each one of us is unique. Each one of us has a purpose, our own unique purpose. We pray, Father, that you would encourage us as we look around at the other members of the body of Christ here in this place, to see our purpose and to see our purpose fulfilled. Father God, we want to be obedient to your calling. So we pray that you would refresh us today with your Holy Spirit, that the scales may fall from our eyes and we may see your purpose for us and your purpose for us within your body. As each of us prays this morning, we bring before you the concerns of our hearts. We think of folk in the extended body of Christ. We think of our friends, of our neighbors. We think particularly of our families. And as the third wave starts to sweep across South Africa, we pray for those who care for us, for those on the front line, carers in hospitals and clinics, for doctors, for nurses. We pray for the health services, but we also pray for those we know who are suffering already, who are sick. We pray ahead into those areas where we know there is going to be sickness as COVID takes its toll. Father, you have brought to us as again part of the body for the common good, scientists and others who understand about vaccines. So we pray for this vaccine program, that you would work in it and through it, and so bring the protection that we need in our country. As we pray for our country, we pray for unity. We pray for unity in all the various areas of our life. We pray for our politics, for our economy. We pray for the commercial world. And we pray your peace upon every single aspect of our lives. We pray that you would fill this land with your Holy Spirit, and that we may all as one bring glory to your name. Father, we ask all of this in the name of Jesus. Amen. Shall we say together, God bless Africa, guard her children, guide her leaders, and give us peace for Jesus Christ's sake. Amen. Right, here come the notices. I'm afraid I'm so out of touch with what's happening at All Souls, but there we go. And although church is open, the service is still being streamed as well. You'll get that on YouTube. That series is nearly coming to an end now. It has been highly successful. I love the footnote on one of those advertisements. Wives, please bring your husbands. I think what the priest was trying to say was there's going to be all sorts of stuff and the husbands will get interested too. But the way he put it, it sounded like any wife who wanted to get rid of a spare husband could just... Okay, this is a very important one, 24/7 prayer. And Bruce and Bully would like to visit you. Okay, so I think that's it, is it, Norma? Yes. Yeah, that's it. Right, so let's stand for the peace. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Peace be with you.
Offertory hymn is Gracious Spirit, Holy Ghost, taught by you we covet most. Don't put it on too tight, it doesn't open.
Yours, Lord, is the greatness, the power, the glory, the splendor, and the majesty. For everything in heaven and on earth is yours. All things come from you, and of your own do we give you. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer. We jumped ahead there, sorry. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. For us it becomes the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. For us it becomes the cup of salvation. Blessed be God forever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and indeed our duty and joy, Lord and Heavenly Father, God Almighty and Eternal, always and everywhere to give thanks through Jesus Christ, your only Son, our Lord. Because through him you have created everything from the beginning and formed us in your own image. Through him you delivered us from the slavery of sin when you gave him to be born as man, to die on the cross and to rise again for us. Through him you claimed us as your own people when you enthroned him with you in heaven, and through him sent out your Holy Spirit, the giver of life. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we acclaim you and declare the greatness of your glory. We praise you now and forever, saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Would you like to sit? Hear us, Father, through your Son, Christ our Lord. Through him accept our offering of thanks and praise, and send your Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts of bread and wine, so that they may be to us his body and his blood. For on the night that he was betrayed, he took bread, and when he had given you thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this and eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. So too, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given you thanks, he gave it to them, saying, Drink of it, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this in remembrance of me. And so we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Holy Father, with these your gifts, we your people celebrate before you the one perfect sacrifice of Christ our Lord, his rising from the dead and his ascending to the glory of heaven. Gracious Lord, accept us in him, unworthy though we are, so that we who share in the body and blood of your Son may be made one with all your people of this and every age. Grant that as we await the coming of Christ our Saviour in the glory and triumph of his kingdom, we may daily grow into his likeness, with whom and in whom and through whom, by the power of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour be given to you, Almighty Father, by the whole company of earth and heaven, throughout all ages, now and forever. Amen. As Christ has taught us, we are bold to sing. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Amen. The bread which we break, is it not a sharing of the body of Christ? We who are many are one body, for we all partake of one. We who are many are one body, for we all partake of the one bread. That's the truth of sharing together in Holy Communion. We each take Jesus within us, and we become one, not only with him, but with each other, for the common good. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. O Jesus, Redeemer of the world, give us your. And so now draw near and receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood which he shed for you. Feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is gracious. Father Almighty, we offer ourselves to you as a living sacrifice in Jesus Christ our Lord. Send us out into the world in the power of the Holy Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. And may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep our hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon us and remain with us always. Amen. Now go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.